All right, so maybe in the background of some of the other videos, you guys have seen this colorful stuff on the wall or whatever. This is the area of one of our like more regular members down here at the bottom. It's John Knoll of Knoll Doubt. And he's got a bunch of crazy stuff. He's always doing laser stuff. He's always doing ShotBot stuff. And I know he's working on some art stuff because he's got a big art show coming up, or he has had art stuff in the back. He's getting more into some art stuff, and he's got this stuff set out, and I saw him working in the wood shop over here on some bamboo star thing. So let's go check it out and talk to him about it. Hey guys.
Awesome. Hey, what's up, fellas?
Hey John, what are you working on?
I am working on a piece of artwork. This is a 1-inch thick piece of bamboo that I cut out on the ShotBot. I'm really interested to sand it first, and then I'm going to put some shellac on it and really make these inside things pop out.
Yeah. How did you come up with the design?
So this is actually an original design I drew up years and years ago. I actually have it tattooed on me.
Oh, really?
Yeah. This is a star that helps bring me home.
I'm glad I asked. That is a cool story. I thought you were just going to be like, I Googled it.
No. I drew this up years ago.
That is cool. And you know, something I like about this bamboo is I've done a couple things with it. All of our like upstairs tables are with it. I know you've done a bunch of stuff with it. It's actually like these veneers. You can kind of see it maybe a quarter inch. Nah, it's not even that. It's an eighth inch. And then these vertical plies is the center like ply.
Yeah.
And then the bottom is the other veneer. It's very cool. And I like what you're mentioning there, where when you sand these, you'll really get a sense of like that construction of it.
For sure.
Because bamboo is like the little reeds. People don't think about that when they see bamboo plywood. It's like, there's no bamboo tree really. It's kind of those, like the shoots.
That is correct. Yeah, when I first made this design, my plan was to put LED lights in these channels have this be the back of the thing.
Oh, okay.
But after looking at the other side, this side just looked way cooler. And especially with the bamboo down in the channels, like you said, it goes up and down. So it'll really be cool when it's done.
How do you, I know you said you've got this design that you originally did.
Uh-huh.
So what program do you use? Do you use AutoCAD? Do you actually get in the ShotBot stuff?
So for this design, when I originally drew it, I just did paper and pencil.
Sure.
You know what I mean? And then I work within Corel Draw because I do a lot of stuff on the laser. So that's what I prefer to work in. And then just bring it over from Corel, just bring over my vector.
Nice.
Onto the ShotBot.
Yeah, that's actually, I think that's how we used to teach. Maybe we still do, but we used to teach the ShotBot classes where we would draw something out, scan it or take a photo of it, turn it into a vector. That is an interesting skill to be able to use the ShotBot to eventually make these precise shapes out of that.
Yeah, I've made it a few times on the laser before, but obviously the laser's limited to size and thickness. So it's cool to take something over to transition it on the ShotBot.
What is the goal? What are you going to do with this eventually?
So this is actually, I'm making it. It will be for sale on my website. Mm-hmm. But in the meantime, I'm going to hang it at my house.
Cool.
Yeah.
And then you think maybe you're not going to do LEDs, or are you still going to do LEDs?
No LEDs on this. I have another version, a smaller one that I did a prototype with. Mm-hmm. I'm going to actually put a piece of wood on the back part here, and then I'm going to pour a resin in it and add some like metal swirls and sparkly things too. But that's a totally different one, not this one.
Awesome. And how about that stuff? We walked by it on the way in here, but the really colorful zigzag stuff on your bench.
Okay, yeah. Those are What's just other pieces of artwork. I have my studio over at Chrome Edge, and we're open up for Franklinton Friday, so I just enjoy making art and colorful things.
Is that what you're doing? You're getting ready for?
Franklinton Friday is this Friday.
It's 2 days from now.
Yeah. And then, so there's the one main colorful squiggly line piece, and then if you notice behind that, there's a piece that is just the scraps from that turned into another piece of artwork.
Cool. Yeah, that's something that's like your signature, is finding like these crazy shapes that happen to be like the negative of what you were doing and then actually using it for something.
Yeah, negative space is great.
Awesome. All right, thanks for talking about the project, man. It's very cool. I had no idea that you had designed this shape yourself.
For sure.
Cool.
All right, thanks, fellas.